Good morning, students. Welcome back in computer science class. Today, here I am going to explain you about functions. Okay, functions. It is the first topic in the third unit. Okay, what are the functions and what is the use of the functions? Why we are using that functions in C programming? That I will explain. See, in the very first class, I have explained the structure of C programming. In the structure of C programming, I have explained the main function, and after the main function, after closing the main function, sub function 1, sub function 2, like that. This structure I have already explained. Okay, so now in our today's topic functions, you need to discuss about this area. What is the sub function? How to write that sub function? How to execute that sub function? That we'll discuss. Okay, so actually, what is the use of the sub function? Example. Before going into detail. So, example, you have a C programming. What is the purpose of that C programming? Is why you are writing the C program is you are writing a program for addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, module, square root, average, tan, cos, like that. You are writing program for all the arithmetic and the logical operations. So in a single program, imagine this is a single program. In a single program, when you write all these functions, it is nearly some 1000 lines of code. Okay, how many lines of code? 1000 lines. In that 1000 lines, what you have written? You have written all these functions like this. Add. Add means C equals to A plus B. Next, subtraction. C equals to A minus B. Next, multiplication like this. So when you write all the functions, it is nearly the size of the program will be 1000 lines of code. Okay, so that whatever functions you have written, if you write all the functions in the single program only, okay, I have written all these functions in a single program, right? So at the time of execution, just I want to calculate sum of two numbers. Okay, how many lines of code we have? 1000 lines. That 1000 line, in that 1000 lines, I have written nearly some 20 to 30 functions I have written. Example. So out of that 30 and 40 functions, I want to execute only one function. That is a addition of two numbers. So in actually in when you execute the program, as I already said, your program starts from the main function. So in the main function part, whatever lines are there, whatever program is there, the entire code, all these functions are written inside the main function. Inside the main function, I have written all this code. So what happened? When your program is starting execution, if it is not needed also, this 1000 lines of code will be loaded into your program. Okay, actually what is my requirement? I want to execute only addition of two numbers. So if where is that addition of two numbers? Here in this program. But in that program, addition to the addition of number, how many programs still, how many functions you have? 30. So if you have written all these 30 functions in the same program, in the same block, even though if you are not needed, that all the functions are loaded into memory. And all the functions will be executed. Okay, so here what happened? When if it is not needed, the 1000 lines of code are loading into the memory and it is executed. So 1000 lines of code is executed. Actually, I want only 4 lines of code. But how many lines of code is executing? 1000 lines. So it required execution time. So when execution time is more, that program performance will come down. Okay. See, once again I am explaining, we have one function, one program, A.C. In that A.C program, I have written 30 functions. Okay, and 30 function, the total program size is 1000 lines of code. Over program I have written, I have compiled, okay. So, but when, what is my requirement, what I want from the program? I have 30 functions, but at a time I don't want 30 functions. I want it to only one function, addition of two numbers. So, but if these 30 functions are in the only, in the main program, so if you require or not, it doesn't matter. All the programs, all the functions will be loaded into the memory. Okay, it increases program execution time because 30 lines, 1000 lines of should be loaded into the memory. It should be compiled, it should be executed. So it will increase the execution time and it will decrease the program performance. Understood? If you write all this code, all these functions inside the main function. Okay, for this problem, in C programming, we have one solution. What is the solution? Yes. Here I am writing a main function. Main function, as already said, your program execution starts from the main. This is a main function. Okay? And whatever functions you have written, like addition, subtraction, multiplication and division, here we write. Add, C equals to A plus B, subtraction, next to multiplication, plus and division, all these functions are different. Okay? So whatever functions you are writing, that functions I am writing after closing the main function. Once the main function is closed, your program execution will be X. Then you may get a question, when, how this function will be executed? Then what happened is, we'll write a code for all the functions. But which function you want to execute, that function will call from the main function like this. C equals to add 10, 20. Suppose if I write this statement inside the main function, as already said, C program is a structured programming. In the same sequence how you have written, in the same sequence your program will be executed. So when control comes to this line, it goes to the addition function. It will execute this block and whatever output we are getting that block, that will be stored in C and that result will be printed C. Example. This is a procedure actually. So here, what happened? Here I have 30 functions. But which function I am calling? Only addition I am calling. Only that function will be loaded into your memory and that will be executed. The remaining will not be executed. Okay. So example, I want multiplication also. Again, D equals to multiplication 2, 20. So when control comes to this line, it will go to the multiplication and it will calculate C equals to A into B and it will return the result to the D and that will be printed. D only. Example. Okay, so in this case, what advantage you have? Whatever functions you have, whatever function you need, only that will be called, that will be loaded, that will be executed. The remaining will not be loaded. So when the remaining functions are not loaded into the memory, what happened? Program execution will be fast, your program performance will be increased. One more thing is, unnecessary code is not loaded and unnecessary code is not compiled. See, in the example here, I want addition and multiplication only. Example, I have not used this function constant that I have written. Then what if there is a mistake in a division and a square root? It will give an error. We have to correct that error. Again, we have to compile. We have to execute. But I don't want that function. Square root function, I don't want. Division, I don't want. What I want actually, addition, I want. Addition and multiplication. In that two functions, there is no error. Okay, so where is the error in division and square root? but your program is not executing because of the two functions. So in this case, what happened is whatever functions are needed, only that function can be executed. Okay, that is the use of the concept. So actually, what is the function is? Whatever total C programming is there, whatever program is there, the total program is divided into a different parts, and each and every part we use to perform, we will write to perform a specific task. And whenever you want a result from that task, whenever you want to execute that task, only we'll call that block. We won't call the remaining blocks. That is a function concept. Okay. And one more advantage is we have is, see here, first time I have calculated C equals to A plus B, like a 10 comma 20. The same function you can call again. See here I have given C equals to A, add 10 comma 20. Again, C equals to add 30 comma 40. That block is same, but I am calling once again with the different values. Okay, that facility is also available using the functions. Same functions you can call unlimited number of times with the different values. Okay, see example I have written one function to calculate total marks of the student, 5 subject marks. 100 students are there. Okay, total how many subjects are there? 5 subjects. How many students are there? 1000 students are there. So 1000 students, you can use the same function. Example, this is for student 1, this is for student 2, this is for student 3. Here I can give a different value, but function is same. The same values will be stored. Different values will be stored in the same memory location. Okay, so using the function concept, what happened is, whatever block you have written to perform a specific task, that can be reused number of times. Okay, so that is why function is called as self-contained block. Okay, self-contained block of statements. Here, in the function you can write any number of statements, depends on your requirement. All the statements can be reused number of times when you call the function. So here this is called as a calling a function. So when you call the function, that function will be loaded into your memory and that will be executed. Okay, so what is a function? Function is a block of statements. Okay, block of statements which are written to perform a specific task. Okay, what is a function? Function is a block of statements, okay, which are used to perform a specific task. When the function will be executed? When the user calls the function. At that time only the function will be executed. See, here in this program we have written 30 functions. But which function is executing? Which you are calling? Okay, so when the function execution will be start, when you call the function, at that time only the function execution will be start. Okay, so this is a introduction about functions. Okay, so now we'll discuss a little bit more about functions. So here we have some uses of functions. What is the first one? Is what advantages you have in functions? It is avoiding rewriting the same code, as I already explained. Addition I have explained. First time C equals to add 10 comma 20. Next second time add 20 comma 30. Okay. So if you want to calculate sum of two numbers and different values, like A value is 20 and B value is 30. With the different values, if you want to calculate sum of two numbers, again you have to write a same code once again if you won't use the function concept. So if you are using the functions concept, what is the main advantage is you can reduce the rewriting the same code. If you won't use the function C equals to A plus B with the values 10 comma 20, D equals to A plus B like value 20 and 30, you have to declare more number of variables. And C equals to A, this one, D equals to this one, like 20 comma 30. So what happened for new variables, again you have to allot a memory. Okay, memory wastage is decreased using the function. The second one is, same function can be called number of times.
same function, the previous example, in this example only, add 10 comma 20 and add 20 comma 30. Okay, same function can be called number of times using a different values. Okay, same function you can call even 1000 times also using a different values. Okay, that is advantageous because block is same. We are substituting a values. Instead of writing a same logic once again, you can manage with only the single code if you supply different values. Okay, the third one is debugging and executing is very easy. Debugging means what? Checking an error, finding an error. So, if there is an error, you can search in that function only. You don't need to search for the remaining code. Okay, so that is why debugging very easy and executing is also very easy if you are using a function concept inside the C programming. Because whatever total program is there, that you are dividing into a blocks. If there is any error, we'll search in that particular block only instead of searching the total entire program. Okay, that is also one advantage. Next one, complexity of program can be reduced. See, if you write all the code in single program, it is difficult to understand what is the use of each and every line. But if you are dividing whatever total program is there into a blocks, it is easy for you to understand what is the use of the block and what output you are getting from that block. Okay, and if you want to change anything, if you want to modify the code, you can modify only that block, not complete the remaining programming. Okay, and the next one is, it is easy to understand because whatever total program is there, that we are dividing into a section. It is easy for the user to understand what is the purpose of that block, what is the purpose of that function. And one more advantage is, here using the functions, you can increase your program performance. How your program performance is increased? Because whichever block you want to execute, only that block we are loading into your memory. We are not loading the remaining blocks. So, indirectly it is reducing the compilation time, execution time it is reducing. So, when your program execution time is reducing, what it means your program performance will be increased. So, many number of advantages we have. The main advantage is reusability. Whatever block you have written for a specific task, that block you can execute number of times with the different values. See, if you want to calculate total and average marks of 1,000 students, only 6 lines of code is enough. Okay, because same code will use for each and every student, just you need to give a different values. Okay. And that is the use of the function. So when you come to a C programming, there are different types of functions. Okay. That different types of functions, actually main two categories we have here. Here, types of functions. In C programming, we have two types of functions. Okay, the first one is library functions, library predefined names, synonyms, predefined. The second one is user defined. Okay, how many types are it is? Library functions, predefined functions. They may ask question, explain predefined function or library functions. Both are same. User defined functions, that is different. It is only one name we have. Okay, just see the extension of this. I will explain library functions in this class now. See, here, first category I will explain library functions are predefined function. Yeah. See, library function, predefined function. What are the predefined and library functions? See, when you load the software, with the software, you will get some functions in order to write the program, to help the user to write the program. Such functions are called as a predefined functions, library function. In C programming also, when you load the C software, from the software you will get a different functions help the user to write the program. Okay, so such type of functions, you need to call that function. You no need to write a body of the function, what is the use of that function, you no need to write. These are the ready-made functions. Just you need to call the functions. Okay, see here I will give you an example. Printf is a function. Okay, because here you have a parenthesis, it is a function. What, how to write the printf statement and what is the body of that function? Nothing I am giving. Just I got this function from one library file and I am executing. Okay, so here if I give like this, hello, whatever you have given, that is printed on the output screen. But how to print, how to collect a value from the user, I didn't mention anything. Just I am writing the function and I am giving the value. This is called as a function call. Function call. If I do, if it is an integer, I will give like this. Printf a, that is printed on the screen. But what is the variation between a string and what is the variation between a string and a integer value? That whatever instruction is there, that instruction I have not given. In library functions, whatever instructions are there, what is the body of the function? Everything is compiled, executed, everything is over. It's ready made, it's ready to use. Just you need to pass the value. Okay. So in a library function, the user will not mention anything, the user will not give anything. Just the user need to call the function by passing the values. Okay, in the previous example I have given like this. C equals to add 10 comma 20. Here this body I don't know, just I am calling by passing the value. Similarly, here just I am calling the function, printf function, by passing the value. But what is the body of that printf function? I don't know. Okay. Because it is already defined, predefined. It is already executed. As a user, just I am giving a value. Okay, I want that function. In order to execute the value, you need to pass the value. Just I am passing the value and I am calling the function. Okay. Understood? So, predefined functions are the functions which you get from a software. And that functions already means the body of the function is already defined, that is already executed, that is already, everything is over. Just you need to call that function by passing the value. That are called as a predefined functions. Printf, scanf, getchar, main functions, different functions. All those functions are all predefined. So direct if you want to directly define what is a predefined means, whatever functions we are getting from a C software, that are already means that are all predefined or library functions. If in our C programming we have a facility to create our own functions, means a user can create his own function like a printf function and scanf, such functions are called as a user defined functions. User defined functions. Okay, so whatever functions means according to the user requirement. If the user is having his own code which is required number of times in the program, okay, the user can create his own functions. That functions are called as a user defined functions. But what if it is a user defined function, there is a procedure how to create a function, how to give the body of that function, how to pass the values to that function. Everything is a step-by-step procedure. If it is a user-defined, if it is a predefined, that procedure is already over. But if it is a user-defined, everything you have to mention from the creation to calling. Okay, so that each and every step we'll discuss in the next class. Okay, so in the next class in detail I'll explain how to create user-defined functions in C program.